My name is Alberto Ortona. I am professor of advanced materials here at SUPSI, and I am leading the hybrid materials laboratory, where we study hybrid materials and hybrid process to make those materials.
We are in a university of applied science, and we are located in the southern region of Switzerland. Here in our lab, we do a lot of research, but applied research starting from the additive manufacturing of ceramic components, going through the thermal treatment of these kind of special materials.
We are very much focusing on ceramic materials. So at the end, our goal is to produce porous ceramic materials with engineered properties for different applications.
Some applications can be, for example, a modern version of heat exchangers, water filtration elements, or catalysts.
Typically, when we do this porous material, we print a polymeric, which we call template, on which we can put a ceramic paste, which then after heat treatment becomes a ceramic.
The beauty of the 3D printing technologies are that you can produce more or less whatever you want. So this gave us the possibility to design our own structures based off what we need. Up to now, we were using just SLA technique, but with that, it was not possible to achieve porous polymeric objects. This is why we are now investigating the SLS technique. We bought this Sintratec kit, which allows us to produce porous components. For example, these porous structures are called gyroid.
Comunque la stampante della Sintratec ha delle ottime potenzialità perché mi permette di variare I parametri avendo un ampio range, quindi posso scegliere di ottenere parametri con proprietà meccaniche più alte e porosità più basse o viceversa, aumentare la porosità e ridurre le proprietà meccaniche e inoltre mi permette di definire delle geometrie particolari e soprattutto come per il pezzo come il giroide, una geometria complessa la macchina la riesce a realizzare in maniera molto facile.
The size and shape of these samples is the same, but they were produced with different printing parameters. In general, one of the methods that we use to evaluate the performances of our advanced materials is to test it through a compression test. The goal of this test is to check which kind of printing parameters give us the best performance in terms of mechanical properties.
We entered in a complete new world because in our case, our structures are so complex that you can not simply do them, but with additive manufacturing. Because if you want to do what we call the engineered porous architectures, there is no way. I mean, you have to pass through additive manufacturing.